Hello everybody, my name is Ali and in this video I'm going to share with you the fastest and most effective method to find a profitable product with high demand and low competition. So you can learn, use and come up with a few product ideas and successfully launch your own private label product on Amazon. So I'm going to use the Black Box, a tool by Helium 10, which is one of the best software for Amazon FBA. If you want to give it a try, I'll leave down in the description so you can have a 30-day free trial and 50% off on your subscription after that free trial. So without further ado, let's get into it. All right, here in the Helium 10 Black Box, I want to give you guys a quick tour and show you exactly how these filters work so you'll know how to navigate it by yourself. Now, at the top right corner, you're going to pick which marketplace you want to search in. You can select Amazon.com, which is the biggest marketplace, Amazon Canada, Germany, Spain, France, Italy, and the UK that you can run the searches on. Right next to that, in case you miss something or want to reopen a search result, hopefully you can click on Restore Last Search and it brings up your last search result. You can also save a project and load that specific project that you saved before. Now, on the left side, there are five different tools. The first one is Product Tools, and you're able to search for products that meet whatever criteria you're looking for. Now, a lot of courses and other videos show you how to use the products tool. You can select which category you're interested in. You can do the monthly revenue, price, review count, and so on. And you can watch my other video if you want more information on that. But in this video, I want to show you a different way and teach you how to use the keywords tab. So when it comes to keywords, the most important criteria is search volume. And search volume means the estimated number of times Amazon customers search for a product in a given month. So in other words, it's the estimated monthly search volume. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find something with a minimum of, let's say, 30,000 search volume. Keep in mind, there is no magic number here. I entered 30,000. You can enter whatever works best for you. In some categories, even there could be amazing opportunities with 10,000 or even 5,000 search volume. So 30,000 here, there is no need to enter the maximum number. Next, we have monthly revenue, which says how much money Amazon sellers are making in the keywords that we're gonna find. Let's say we want something that makes at least $10,000 every month. I usually leave the price empty. You can say, for example, you're looking for a product from $15 up to $30. But personally speaking, I'll leave it empty because honestly, I don't care about this filter or price. Now, review count is definitely a good one because the fewer reviews, the less competitive that product or keyword is. So let's say we want an average of less than 300 reviews. Next, you can enter the review rating, which can be helpful because you can set it to show you only 1-star or 3-star reviews, which means there is a problem with that product. You can read the negative reviews and try to improve the product you're looking for based on those 1-star or 3-star reviews. Finally, we have word count, which is the number of words in the keyword phrase we're looking for. I always enter a minimum of 2 words because obviously one-word keywords are too broad, general, and useless as well. For example, if someone searches for fitness, you can tell he's just browsing. But if someone searches fitness bands, you can tell he's looking for resistant band. So let's go ahead and click on search. There are tons of Halloween related stuff here. I'm recording this video in October, and in just 3 weeks there will be Halloween. And this shows this tool is great for finding seasonal products as well. As you can see, the first result is Tombstone's Halloween decor with almost 37 search volume, an average price of $21, average monthly sales of $13,000, and only 145 reviews. If you click on these little 3 dots on the right side, it opens the Amazon search results. Here we have a few Halloween Tombstone decors. There is a 1-star product, there is a 3-star product. There are 2 main products with 25 and 149 reviews, but the reviews are just 3.5 stars. So if I want to dig deeper, I always go through the bad reviews and read them and try to come up with a better product. Now let's move to the next product. The next keyword is Squid Game. Now I'm recording this video in the first week of October, and if you watch Netflix, you already know this Squid Game has been in the top 10 list on Netflix, and the whole social media and Instagram are packed with its pictures, videos and memes. Literally everyone is talking about it. So I believe it's a great opportunity, not only because of Halloween, but also because people love it and they keep buying its costumes even after the Halloween. As you can see, it has more than 80,000 searches every month, which is way too much for a keyword. I usually aim for 30,000 searches, but this one seems amazing. The average price is $22, monthly sales is $12,000, and the average review isn't even one. So let's go ahead to Amazon and see the search results. The reviews are almost zero, which is perfect. There are different product opportunities, which means you can launch different variation at once. I like the keyword and I believe there is tons of money if you launch a product, but let's go into the next keyword. The next keyword is passport and vaccine card holder combo. It has more than 120,000 searches every month with an average price of $10. Average sales is $35,000 and 95 reviews, but let's check that on Amazon. As you can see, there are pretty similar to each other and reviews are all under 200, which shows this category isn't that competitive yet. Personally, I consider anything above 1,000 reviews a competitive category, but this one is under 200. Which is a good sign. Most of these products are being sold for $10, and I'm sure the purchasing price is under 50 cents. And they are so small and light, so if you want to differentiate it, you can bundle two or three together with different colors for couples or families. Let's go ahead to the next product. The next keyword is axolotl plushie. To be honest, first I didn't even know how to pronounce it, and after searching on Google, I realized it's a Mexican salamander. And this is the whole point of doing this. You want to see things that you have never seen before. Until a few minutes ago, I didn't know something like this even exists, but apparently people are searching for it on Amazon 44,000 times a month. Product research used to be the most boring part of starting your Amazon FBA business, but hopefully with this tool it gets more entertaining. You can spend 1 hour on product research and come up with at least 15 to 20 new product ideas and opportunities every single month. But before purchasing your product on Alibaba, make sure to check if these products aren't patented or they don't have any legal restrictions like trademarks and other stuff. If you want to use Helium 10, I'll leave a link down in the description and you'll get 30 days free trial plus 50% off on your monthly subscriptions. If you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Make sure to check out my two new courses, Amazon FBA Mastery and Alibaba to Amazon Mastery. They are affordable courses with 30-day money back guarantee. I'll leave a link down in the description if you want to check them out. Now, if you have any questions, make sure to comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Also, make sure to watch my other videos over here. There are tons of valuable tips and tricks you don't want to miss in these videos, so click on one of them right now. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.